I find most Indians to be very logical people. So, you know, you just have to go through the objects logically, and it's kind of easy to figure out.
Well, just because you said that, we're going to let this go. Joe, we're going to play this super fun game with you. It's called Superstars Ki Paathshala, which translates to the WWE School for Superstars. All right, I'm going to show you a couple of images. Now, these images are very, very Indian in nature. They're objects that you most certainly and most commonly find in Indian households or in and around India. Now, you're going to get four options with each image. All you got to do is guess the right option that connects with the image. All right?
Okay.
Okay, great. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, let me see your game face. I need to see your game face. Yeah, all right. We got a game face on. Let's have the first image. Ooh. There's something that this guy is eating. What could it be? Let's have our options.
Okay. Someone about to have a mouth freshener.
Okay, why would you choose that option? What's the reason behind that?
This dude with the, see this guy holding the leaf, he looks like he's pretty smart. You know what I mean? He looks like he knows what he's doing. You know, he's not approaching this like a really terrible friend who's about to play a prank on you, like, like that. No, he looks like he's confident in what he's doing. So
right.
I think I'm gonna go with the medicine.
You're gonna go with the medicine, the Ayurvedic medicine for cough and cold.
Yes.
Are you sure?
I think yeah. Mouth freshener? I said mouth freshener originally, right?
Yes, did you it? Did.
And then I did.
You applied logic to it and then came up with the Ayurvedic medicine.
Yeah, you know what? I think my logic made me, it's the guy. That guy seems like he knows what he's doing. I'm gonna go with medicine, cough and cold.
Okay, Ayurvedic medicine for cough and cold. Let's find out if Samoa Joe is right or wrong.
I was originally right.
You are right. So this is how it's assembled, it's made. It is very, very commonly found in India. This is something that we consume mostly post meals, and it helps with digestion.
Oh, wow.
This is how it's made.
Yeah, that looks very, very cool. You should try that next time we're out.
Woo! Interesting. A lime and a couple of chilies. So let's see what this could be. What are the options?
I'm gonna say a device to ward off the evil eye.
A device to ward off evil eyes.
Yeah.
Okay. Feeling confident about that?
No, not at all, but we'll see how it does.
Okay. You've taken your bet, you've taken your chance. Let's find out if your answer is correct or not. Yes, it is a device to take to ward off evil eyes, and it's very, very commonly found in India as well. It's mostly hung in cars, even outside homes sometimes. And this is known to kind of take off all the bad eyes and all the evil eyes and all the bad spirits and all of that. So well done. Good job.
Good.
Give yourself
know.
A pat on the back.
I will. There we go.
Very well deserved. Very well deserved. All right, let's take a look at the next image. There you go. And let's have our options.
A spinning toy, final answer.
Have you seen something like that around, which is why you're so confident?
No, but I'm pretty sure just looking at it mechanically, it looks like a spinning toy.
Yeah. I mean, it could also be a civil instrument for architects. I'm not giving you any answers. I'm just kind of trying to...
No, I know that. I think architects are not very, I don't think they would like the bright colors on top of their instruments. You know what I mean? I think they're very precise individuals who like the things, nice, clean, industrial lines, nice, clean, industrial look and aesthetic to it. So I don't know. It seems like a joyful device to me, you know, the way it's colored.
Oh, the architect is just a happy guy. I mean, that could also be the thing.
It could be that. There are a few happy architects, not many, but I've heard there are a few.
All right. So are you going to stick with spinning toy?
Yes, I go with spinning toy.
Okay, let's see if the answer is correct or not. It is a spinning toy. Well Samoa Joe. Not bad. This is also commonly known as Lattu. It's a toy that's designed to be super fun. It's used in India. A lot of kids play with it. So if you could repeat after me, since I'm educating you on all things yes. Indian. A Lattu.
A Lattu.
That's right. Very well done. Let's take a look at the options.
I don't know. Rolling pin just doesn't seem like it would serve the purpose that stated. Traditional dumbbell. Can't really tell the size of it. I have seen traditional Indian weights. You know, I've seen the eels and clubs and the maces and the gada maces and stuff like that. So that doesn't look like any of those instruments I've seen before. So I don't think it's that. Wine bottle cork. A little complicated for a wine bottle cork. Cork's a pretty simple device. Just plug it in the hole. I'm going to go with cricket bail.
You're going to go with cricket bail?
Yes.
Okay, clear and pure logic applied to this answer of yours. You've kind of worked your way from eliminating what does not work and then you're left with the cricket bail. Now let's see if this logic truly works. It does! This is a cricket bail. Congratulations!
Woo-hoo! And also, cricket is played very much in Samoa as much as it is in India. So it was kind of, I was kind of cheating.
That's right. You are killing this. You are smashing this. This is, you've hit a straight six. Moving on, what is this? Can we have the options?
It's a lot of bells for cattle. And musical instrument, there's a better way to play a bell than that. Neck piece, a little much for a twerk. I'm gonna go with anklets. I think anklets.
You're gonna go with anklets?
Yeah.
Why? I'm going to ask you why.
I'm going to say the strapping, the binding. If it was a musical instrument, it would be, you know, kind of a more stationary device, something that would have a little bit more control to it, because obviously you want to control the tempo of the bells. The looseness, the fabric, it all leads me to believe that those are meant to be bound around something, preferably a wrist or a neck.
Or around a neck, maybe? I don't know.
There wouldn't be two.
It could be a fashion statement. Okay, I'm just going to go with what you're saying. I'm trying really hard here. All right, let's see. These are anklet bells, also known as ghungroos. Very, very commonly worn by Indian classical dancers. I don't think there's anything left to teach you. Because you
don't
know.
There's always
crazy.
Something new.
You're getting it all right.
Well, you know, hey, I find most Indians to be very logical people. So, you just have to go through the objects logically and it's kind of easy to figure out.
Well, just because you said that, we're going to let this go. Indians are logical people. Yes, everybody in this room. Feel good. Okay, great. Amazing. You got that one right. Congratulations. Let's take a look at the next image. Okay, now let's see if you can crack this one. Here are your options. This one's tricky.
It is. I want to say bed, but that is an unusual way to store a bed. portable partition. I think there's easier ways to make partitions. Vintage trampoline would definitely not hold up to a good jumping up and down by some really crazy kids. I don't know. At least not my kids. I know they would tear that thing apart. I don't know, the thatching, kind of how it's set up against the wall, like your carpet maker?
So are you going to go with that?
Yeah, I think carpet maker.
Okay, let's see if you got the right answer. Finally, you can get the right answer, Samoa Joe, it's a bed!
Well, it being on its side kind of got me. It got me.
Right.
I don't know everything.
It's generally stored like that. It's generally kept like that when it's not in use. But this is a good old Indian traditional bed. Commonly known as a charpai.
Charpai.
That's right. Charpai, which literally translates to four legs. Charpai.
Very cool. He looks comfortable. Amazing. I will give him that.
I can just finally say that I managed to teach Samoa Joe something. And with that, we come to the end of Superstars Ki Paathshala. Thank you so much for this. We had a great time, and honestly, I am completely wowed and floored and impressed with your knowledge of India. You know so much about India already. Now, all that's left for you to do is actually come here and experience all the good food and all the fun stuff that India has to offer.
Well, hopefully that will be sooner than later.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you so much for joining me on this fun conversation. We wish you all the best for your future, and we can't wait to have you back on WWE Now India.
Take care.
Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye. In Punjabi. In Punjabi. Jinder.
Har.